ate them. I ate them with ketchup, and they were good. You probably want me to get serious about our divorce. You see, the thing is, you always called our marriage a joke, so let's use the logic here. If A, we never had a serious marriage, then B, we can't have a serious divorce. No, we can't. The whole thing is a farce, Charles. A farce that tastes good with ketchup. I mean, wasn't it last week your dad asked you the reason you walked that aisle with me? And you said for the exercise. I'm up for the exercise. It's really funny, Charles. You're a funny guy. I'm laughing, not crying. I'm laughing because you're about to give up on a woman who is infinitely lovable. For instance, Paul. He has loved me since he saw me. He made 124 passes at me, proposed 47 times, and sent me over 200 original love sonnets. He sees something in me, Charles, and he writes it down in meter verse. And that's not something you can just find every day. Someone who really loves you as who you are as a person. Paul may be insane, but I value his feelings for me. I would never ask him to sign his name to a piece of paper promising to just turn off his feelings for me forever. But that's what you're asking me to do for you. To sign away my right to that sweet voice, Charles, those baby brown eyes, and the way your hands feel through my hair before bed. Oh, that's not something that I want to lose. In fact, I won't lose them. I won't lose you. I woo you. I've written you a sonnet. Shall I compare thee to summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate, darling buds of May. And I'm not crying, I'm laughing. It's all a big joke, isn't it? It's very funny, Charles. I keep waiting for you to say April's Fools, and then I'll rush into your arms and... But you're not going to say it. No, of course not. It's not April. I didn't really write that sonnet, you know. Who did? I think it's good. You see, the truth... the truth, Charles, is... I really ate the divorce papers. I ate them because I can't stomach the thought of losing you.